Hello guys, it is your boy Collabris Gaming. If you're wondering why I didn't come to school today, I was hit with a really bad sickness. So I barely feel well enough to even do this video. That's how bad I feel. So I'm just waiting for the Technic Launcher to launch itself. Man, so we can recontinue the challenge. Second installation of the Build the Tunnel Slash Survive Challenge, which I begun previous video in the previous installation. Hopefully I don't get I'm pretty disoriented. I'll basically tell you guys how it happened. The night before, yesterday night, it was I felt perfect. But when I got up dehydrated and decided to take some Sorry, I was reading the splash text. But anyway, I got up, drunk like a whole big cup of water. Probably a very bad idea. And, then after I drank my water, I went back to bed. I still having a hard time sleep though, and I noticed I was, I think, feeling heartburn, I think acid reflux, because I can tell there's this burning sensation coming from my stomach all the way to like my esophagus, which from what I know is actually heartburn. So doing a life hack I heard of on the internet, which was to sleep on your left side. I managed to suppress it for a small bit, but it didn't last forever. However, and so before I knew it, I was throwing up everywhere. Tell you what, even though I felt slightly better after that, the condition I was feeling was going downhill since then. Oh, hey, buddy. Yeah? Sorry about that. My sister was asking me what part of Far Cry Primal am I on my Xbox One? Let's see. Well, sorry, after the bad guys attack the guys from Oro's attack, you know, the cannibals, they actually do a. Well, I. Yeah. Yeah. I'm basically now just exploring and taking hideouts, or not hideouts, but also outposts as I need to, so I can increase my population. Sorry about that, guys. Sister was asking what point of Far Cry Primal was I on and my Xbox One. Whoops, I accidentally fired a shot. Also, if you can tell, my game is not on smooth lighting. You guys are wondering why the lighting seems so spotty. Whew. Sorry about that interruption. I don't think she actually said my name, but I'm glad she didn't say my name, or else I would have to cut this whole video out. And you know, I kind of like doing that. Whoops. Well, this could take a while. I think this stuff like takes like 20 seconds to mine. Because it's supposed to be twice stronger than obsidian. Hey, at least stuff mines. At least the stuff mines, right? Whoops. Bit of a miscalculation. I actually think going every 5 would actually do it better. Cause it makes the lighting a lot more better spaced. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think right here, maybe on the 6th block. Whew. And tell you what, I was laying in bed all day. throughout the whole night, I was vomiting, and the rest of the time, I was having diarrhea, which led to me having some extreme dehydration. Got so bad where I actually lost 6 pounds. That's how bad it got. I actually lost 6 pounds. Losing weight from dehydration isn't, you could say, an okay thing. Whoops. Again. Probably just because of disorientation. Me and my mom have it. My sister is trying to stay away from me. Well, I'm pretty sure, I only had to tell her for her to actually realize that by the time I got sick, I was playing Halo on my Xbox One. And the thing was, I was actually playing Halo 2 fighting against the Flood the same night, so. But the thing is, it's probably ironic that I was actually fighting a nasty creature. YOLO. Whoops. Got skeletons out here. Now we go reclaim this little area for myself. YOLO. I actually named a world YOLO. Believe it or not, my vanilla Minecraft. Since I wanted to test out the Admist application here, which is this is the world YOLO, and that's where I am right now. I don't have YOLO on right now. If you're wondering, I probably should reload by now. Alright, I guess I'll start working on the rocket launcher now. Alright, we're going to get in our little bow pack for the rockets. Wrong one. Oh, I'm getting lag. If you guys cannot tell, I'm getting some serious lag right now. There. Hold on, I have to reload. So yeah, this is one way for me to do nothing. Since my sister's playing Far Cry on my Xbox One, why not do something for my channel, you know? And yes, the reason I haven't uploaded my Nintendo game collection yet is because of the serious it's because of the sickness. If I actually wasn't sick, I probably would have it done by today. You guys are wondering why I hadn't uploaded a personal question video of all my games. And once again, I am still pretty dehydrated. Let me get some water. And so I was sleeping in bed all day. And I hadn't eaten anything for 21 hours. Until about 5 today. Didn't eat anything. And what I ate, that's about yesterday, about 6 or 7. It just fell out of my belly, you could say, when I threw up. So there's no actual way I could actually not say, okay, yep, I ate less than 12 hours ago. Because as I know, that's actually quite impossible. Unless you're sick. Trust me, I've actually skipped meals because I was sick before. And in fact, the thing is, I am more prone to stomach bugs than the actual flu. Now let's see if I can snipe him. Snipe that baby zombie. Oh, I had to reload, really? Bye-bye. Yeet! Oh, lordy, oh no. I destroyed my chest. And I still didn't kill that zombie. I like that blood effect, don't you? Sorry, it's just me playing Halo. I play Halo way too often. Alright, let's see now. How am I gonna clean this mess up? Let's see if I can find the chest. Hopefully I don't have to make my own. Oh, lordy. Let's see if I can start putting half these in here. Yep. Let me see if I can put more stuff away here. More of the stuff I don't need away. Let's see. That 64 dirt will definitely do. Well, definitely make a difference. Run flesh. Remember, I have elite meat, so I really don't need to be snacking on elite meat. That's actually what the meat's called, elite meat. I'm actually serious. And see, I usually like carrying as much ammo as like the games will normally allow you to, so you can't collect too much ammo. I wonder if I could go use some medium rounds. Alright, we got my Magnum here. Trade that in with the shotgun. Now we all shotgun rounds become useless, and I'll start delving into the medium rounds I have. I got an immense amount of medium rounds, you have to say. Alright. I almost had a feeling I was gonna throw up again. So let me go ahead and let's see, put more shotgun rounds away. Oops, in the chest is nowhere to be found. Just chest is absolutely nowhere to be found. I guess I have to wear off the, guess I'll have to go hunting in here for monsters, huh? Guess so, but... just be playing my Mark Armor now. I know, I hear a zombie. I know you're there, buddy. Open up so I can pump some lead into ya. I guess I better go ahead and get the flooring set over here before I do anything else. That's probably would be the most smartest thing to do right now. Also, use some grenades. There. Let's see, metal. So what am I using? I'm using floor pattern. Slight, floor pattern. Surprisingly enough, I was actually, the weapon I was using the most often against the flood was actually the Magnum. Even though that's the least advisable thing to do, and I'll swing on normal, so. Difficulty wasn't too high. Oh, hey, buddy. Yeet. Have to reload. Alright, T1. For the love of God. When I try building in peace, I get, when I don't try to build in peace, I get peace. Gosh. It's the ironic thing, too. I said a pretty big prayer to God since a church service was just being held today. Because, I tell ya, being this sick is not something that is on fleek for me today. Absolutely not on fleek. So I'm trying to like pull these like recordings as long as I can. But sometimes that is a bit tough. Especially when you're sick. I usually sometimes try to push the limits on my body. If I feel good enough, I will try to like record, even though I'm probably like really sick. Okay, I seen Markiplier do it. Just saying, I saw Markiplier doing it once. He got sick with I think it was a cold. And then he started doing a try not to laugh challenge. And of course, he was kind of like flaming against the viewer because he was sick and he didn't want to get flamed because he was sick. I can only understand Markiplier there. I don't want. Normally, someone doesn't want anyone yelling at them, especially when they're sick, because they already had a hard enough time trying to keep the symptoms down. Yep, and here I'm spending 40 seconds of this video fixing mistakes, being stupid costs extra. That's what my biology teacher says. Being stupid cost extra. Now, I'm pretty disoriented right now. Also, it may are is experience coming from this mining block? Anyway, I had a dream where actually Casey finally did add the Marines to Casey Halecraft. I actually had a dream where there were, and you would find about a Pelican wreck for fighting off the Covenant units that were nearby, probably, if not the monsters. So I decided I put on a note. The note the day I had the dream, and also to check whether or not the update was actually made, because more than not, it's probably happening. Since Killer Chief did say that he was gonna add Marines pretty soon, I found that off his website, off his mod's website. And I'm pretty disoriented right now. Yep, hoarding more shotgun rounds. Definitely not a good look. Alright, I guess I'll put the rocket launcher away. Put the rocket launcher away. Get the extra 4 powering out. This is actually the extra 4 powering I got when I accidentally exited into survival mode from creative. If you're wondering. Gosh, explosion was so the amount of rockets I used was so much that some stuff actually got blown all the way over there. And I'm not yet using any Covenant weapons. I want to use all my UNSC and then the Covenant weapons. Flamethrower though is UNSC. It seems to actually work more like a Covenant weapon. With that, I guess that's for more later debate. All right, let's go start on the walls over here. See what I can do with this extra wall material. Dang it, I hate these misplaces. Absolutely old now. And that's why I put a bunch of diamond nearby. So, because I knew my pickaxe was going to break more than once. You feel me? Now I knew at least that was gonna happen. She's dehydrated again. Ah, much better. So if I do suddenly leave the camp for a bit. It's probably because I'm either using diarrhea or have to do something really quickly. Just getting a warning out. So if you guys are wondering or wanting me to explain a bit of a long absence, of course I already would have it explained. Whew. I'm probably gonna need more scaffolding. That's probably, oh, What is this stuff? Kneus? I don't know how to pronounce this, so I'm probably butchering it. And of course, I was playing as the Arbiter last night. I was playing as the Arbiter. Arbiter on Halo. I think Halo 2. Man, the Arbiter got played. And I only packed a few needlers since I really don't know how effective needlers are in this mod. A ton of recharge stations in case. And also, if I need to repair my Mark armor, I got plenty of broken pieces to sort to use as used to get chips. Plenty of titanium, so I can make plenty of vehicles in case I lose a lot of vehicles. You feel me? Yeah, so perhaps I can take a, every once in a while I can take a break from building and actually use this time to use some time to actually hunt some mobs. You know, since I won't be building the entire Let's Play, because you know that would be pretty boring if it did happen. And of course, I tell you, I could tell that the throw-up had some acid in there, because my throat was absolutely burning. I'm not even kidding, I couldn't swallow. In fact, the reason I drank water from the previous night is because I was dehydration, because it got so bad that where my throat was actually hurting from it. In fact, the reason I'm making this tunnel is for the building project, because I really think it would be boring watching someone actually playing on creative. More people tend to like survival more, and so I think that's the direction I'm going. In fact, before I played in creative, I actually did survival back when I first went on the PC. However, it was the exact opposite for Pocket Edition, which I do have. In fact, when it came, I actually got Pocket Edition when it first came out for the Kindle Fire HD, and I played that for a while too. Played it until the Kindle broke. The reason I'm no longer playing it now is not only because it's mobile, but also the control scheme is seriously ruined. God, what's going on? There's so much lag. Hold on. Let me go change the video settings. Let's see, graphics fast, full screen off, VSync on, minimal. Probably got to decrease the frame rate right there. Hopefully that'll make it better. Yep, I'm definitely noticing it's feeling much better. It's nighttime again. Also, I gotta get that dashboard bar out of here. Also, by the way, if you didn't know, because I heard someone actually was at my school making a speech of whether or not we should use Minecraft Education Edition at school, I decided to get myself a copy of it, because I was thinking I was gonna get OSL Captain or Sierra in a little while. Hold on, there we go. I just had to get the bar out there really quickly, because it was getting pretty annoying pretty fast. Just looking at my stuff right now. I have a ton of stuff ready, because I was expecting a seriously good, really, really heavy survival-based game, to where I was in the UNSC, and of course, as I'm restoring this foreigner temple, probably destroyed by the Covenant in the Human Covenant War, which it's very likely that the Covenant don't glass for our facilities, okay? It's very unlikely for that to even happen. But I think what they were doing, what the Covenant were doing in Halo 2, when after Chief killed Regret, the Prophet of Regret, I think they're actually glassing it, because I've seen similar lasers being hit Planet Reach, and I think the concept art. Or at least in the trailer somewhere. So it's possible the Covenant want Earth presence off of their farm facilities, even where they're actually willing to glass it too. Something which they usually advise against. Yeah, this must be like a philosophical rant video. Thirsty again. Drinking some water. Hopefully I don't need to be using the bathroom for diarrhea anytime soon. But I'm pretty sure I got a lot of it out of my system. So what I ate today was very light on the gut. Oh, it's a creeper. He ate. Headshot. Never know. In case gotta check your quarters. Make sure that if there are really any enemies nearby. Now, to me, the hardest thing to do would be the walls and also that over there. And trust me, I can't wait to actually get my Nintendo game collection personally uploaded on YouTube. Because it's more of a like collections like thing, you know. Okay, from what I hear, Nintendo only does copyright strikes because they think it's a review to the game, in which sometimes reviews can be really detrimental to a game's performance when it sells. For one thing, to me that shouldn't apply to a game if Nintendo's not making money from it anymore, you know. For doing a Let's Play upon Chrono Trigger, if it's whether or not it's the original DS or the original SNES version, which I do have the DS version, may I mind you. But, I mean, the reason that copyright laws were set was because it was to prevent patents from being copied and hurt the patent maker detrimentally. Okay, so that's why back then, the reason why I think Joe Zappa, Frank Zappa, didn't want to have music rated was because he actually went up to Congress himself and said, the records are so expensive, and I don't want anything hurting my income. Which, to the mind, explains that piracy happens to music regardless. So to me, doing a Let's Play of Metroid Fusion, as long as it was not being sold on the Virtual Console, that would be fine to me, based on that way of rule. But I'm pretty sure Nintendo would still ban it anyway, because you know how they are with copyright regulations. Okay, every once in a while they can get quite annoying with it. So yes, this is technically off of me addressing the copyright claim that Nintendo filed against me when I was reacting to the Jimmy Fallon debuting the Nintendo Switch. I hear a skeleton. That's why I'm walking around. I wonder if it's over there. Because I know I'm hearing something. I'll get some more light trim blocks. Oh, geez, I almost got stuck in that block for a moment there. And so I would also have to find my Nintendo 3DS XL, which last time I seen it, my sister took it. So it's gonna probably be a while before I get that video out. Oh jeez, fell down. Also, ooh, free carbine. Never know when you're gonna need that. So anyway, I guess speaking about like Cortana, on the Xbox One, I was able to speak to her using the same headset I'm using right now. I plugged it into my Xbox controller, and so when I asked her about Requiem, she's like, "I thought you would never ask." Which means, yes, she is the Cortana from Halo. Considering that Microsoft owns, I think, most some, at least some of the Halo games since Halo was on the Xbox. Xbox Original, 360, and the One. In fact, actually, I actually did at one point have an original Xbox, before the 360, the same one that Halo Combat Evolved was on, but because I inherited it from the same people that gave me their Nintendo 64 and Game Boy Color. In fact, my first Game Boy games did come from the same people that actually owned that Xbox, that Xbox Original. And so anyway, I even had Unreal Tournament. You know the game Unreal Tournament? You probably know that from the engine that actually created it, the Unreal Engine. But anyway, I had Unreal Tournament 2 on the original Xbox. But I traded in for I think some more Nintendo games, because I wasn't all that much of an Xbox fan at the time. Poor Microsoft. Didn't really have a chance to stand against me there. Since at the time, I really liked more Nintendo 4. In fact, I wouldn't go to anything else but Nintendo at the time. My reason, like a lot of other people's reason for getting the Xbox One, was because of Halo. I should get too much water. And so I'm just trying to, record as long as I can. Because you never know when I'm going to need to, throw up sometime. And trust me, throwing up is painful. If you have what I have right now, throwing up will be painful. And so one time, I think with that same money, I actually got Yoshi's Island on the GBA. And the funny thing is, I didn't realize until I beat the first world, but the battery save actually died on it. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. The battery save died? Because you know how battery saves are. They die. And so I still hadn't decided to get that fixed yet. Also, that Sonic Secret Gems collection. The only reason I got that was for Sonic CD, and I had that on my Nintendo GameCube. The only rated M game I've ever actually played aside from Halo was Mortal Kombat 4 on the Nintendo 64. Don't know how, but my relatives would play that game, and so I played it because my uncle. I think my Uncle Tony told me to. To play Mortal Kombat with them, and I really think I really had a hard time getting used to the N64 controls, since it was pretty awkward controls. I hear a skeleton. Get away from me, skeleton! I just want to drive him out of my ghost now. Any damage? Doesn't look like it. Oh, hey, buddy. Take these ghost stingers. So anyway, I think one time I actually I took over a wreath one time just using my UNSC weapons. I think this was like Halo 2 the mission where you would actually kill Regret. But anyway, I thought it was pretty funny. I hear a skeleton. Yeet! Wrong number! I handle that like a pro. Yep. That's gonna be a pretty tough challenge. I might as well go ahead and reclaim my my rocket launcher so I can get rid of the rock over here. Find more rockets. I guess I'll turn off the strategy of like a battle pack system, If you're wondering where I get the name from, that it was not, it's actually from a Halo game. It was actually like how much ammo you could actually carry for one weapon, and for this, like 120 is actually the maximum amount you can carry in Halo Combat Evolved, for the Magnum, which is this over here, the Magnum. Reloading. Hopefully, I'll feel better enough to know to where I can finally find my Nintendo new 3DS XL, if not my Nikon Cybershot camera, because I want to get that video done so bad. I wish they would show reloading animations for half these weapons. I mean, they did stuff like that in Decimation before. If you don't know what the Decimation mod is, it's a pretty good and also almost like totally realistic zombie apocalypse mod. All right, I recommend you get it. I haven't played the newest addition to it, which is Nuclear Winter, but of course I'm saving that for like a co-op video if Zahn will actually play with me the next time around. Since at the time my headset w I did have my headset at a pretty loud setting, so he probably doesn't want to hear what many gamers would call ear rape. Me and Sufwa, we just joked a lot about that last time we spoke, because of my headset. Reloading again. It cancels out the reloading sequence every time you press the fire button. To me, that's actually a bug that might need to be fixed. There we go, reloading. All right, better go ahead and get a little bridge over here to the other side. Never know when I'm gonna need it. Also, I'm starting to feel sick again. Hopefully that doesn't lead me to cut this video short. Once again, I don't want to be thrown up on camera, because that wouldn't have a good rep to it, would it? I'm wondering how much I got left to go before I'm finished with this tunnel. All right, we gotta start putting the floor patterns down. I tell you what, though, I was surprised that you could actually do a rocket jump in this mod. I was pretty surprised that I found out you could actually do that and do like the MLG like rocket jumps. Which scientifically is actually incorrect. You can't do a physical rocket jump because it defies physics. Also, you would actually be more likely to get yourself hurt when you're doing a rocket jump. Fact, I think the rocket jumps were actually invented in TF2, I think. Or at least a game that actually had the same engine as TF2. Forgot the name of the engine. Whoops, misfire. So anyway, in fact, I barely ever play a game that was made by Bandai Namco. Bandai, you know, the makers of Pac-Man, I think. I think Bandai made Pac-Man, or at least someone there. But anyway, the only game I've ever actually played that was from Bandai Namco wasn't just Pac-Man, but also Soul Reavers. God, that is reminding me of Inuyasha right now. Iron Reaver Soul Stealer, you know? Yeah, I'm pretty sure I just triggered at least a few otakus. Not saying that I'm a weeboo or anything, but I know what an otaku is. I watch Gaijin Goomba videos after all. Though, I still kind of don't like the ones about Overwatch. I don't know how that, it just turns me off completely. That I really never like played Overwatch, but from what I heard from Superfly and Red, it was a pretty good game. And probably if I had more enough money, or if I had the time to actually go get the game for, let's say, a Wii U or an Xbox One, if it even is on the Wii U, because if it was on the Wii U, I would be pretty excited, pretty pumped for it. Not 4 seconds wasted mining misplaces. That's probably because the diarrhea of a heaven is severely dehydrating me, but I don't want to drink too much water to where I have to throw up immediately after. Live with pain or live with throwing up because of a fear of dehydration. Plus, water tastes so good when you're dehydrated. Water will literally taste like candy, if you know what I mean. I really hope that me talking about Nintendo products doesn't give me a copyright strike from Nintendo. Considering how reacting to a video that, I wonder if Nintendo didn't give me the copyright strike, did Jimmy Fallon give it to me? If that's the case, I'm sorry, Jimmy Fallon. All right, my mom wanted me to see it last night, and I wanted everyone to react to it. I wanted to react to it. So if it really is you that Jimmy Fallon that sent the copyright strike, I wouldn't blame you because I didn't go to copyright school, obviously. I didn't even know it even existed. Someone's got to tell me all about that stuff, or else I'm gonna really make a fool out of myself one of these days. You see, without enlightenment, you won't know any better without enlightenment, really. And I don't want to use my Mac camera. Even though it probably would have better quality, I wouldn't be able to bring it upstairs. Plus, I don't want anyone to see my real face, and wearing a mask is just a bit claustrophobic. Plus, considering I'm sick, it's probably not gonna have a good feel to it. I almost want to make a Xenoblade Chronicles joke out of that one, but I'm so worried if I do. The makers of the game will sue me. Man, that sounds like a meme I heard on the internet once. Whoops. Dropped my rocket launcher, but somehow it reloaded anyway. I'm starting to feel sick. Hopefully that doesn't mean I have to turn off the camera now because I don't want to. Because then I'll be back to being alone suffering this sickness. Even though my mom's suffering it. It doesn't look like it's actually scathing her too badly. Tell you guys, don't get sick. Especially with the stomach bug, because it could be like really heckish. Don't want to say the bad word. You can say I'm not really in the spirit to say the bad word. Because I know it's probably going to one day bite me in the butt. Because I said a cuss word, I am going to be sick for a long time. Okay. I hear a skeleton. I have my gun ready. I wonder why they don't show the magnifications. Man, the set wrapper reminds me of a microscope. I hear a skeleton again. I wonder if I should throw a firebomb grenade down there. Fire in the hole! I like playing with firebomb grenades. I don't know why. Oh, hey, there's an elite down there. Fire in the hole, elite! And this guy's still wanting to run into the fire. Yep. The elite AI isn't smart as it used to be. And I don't want to fall down there either. Right. I wanted to fling a plastic grenade down there, but I knew if I did. Oh, I almost fell down there. Yep, don't want that happening to me. And falling down a deep hole. Because, you know, that can never have a good rep to it. Unless I was about to die, but once again, I'm sick anyway, so. Whoops. Never misplaced. I heard a skeleton. I get paranoid every time I hear a monster. Just all survival instincts I got from Pocket Edition. But once again, to me, for that copyright strike to happen, I really don't know who filed the copyright strike against me. I know I got copyright stricken. So, the two possibilities I now know of right now is, I think it actually would be Jimmy Fallon, because I'm pretty sure, because even though the annex is not actually released yet, anyhow, I was really excited about it, so I'm pretty sure Nintendo probably wouldn't do a copyright strike against me just because I saw the NX and I really wanted to see it, play with it, you know. But if it is Nintendo, I'm really sorry, Nintendo. If it's Jimmy Fallon copyright strike me, yeah, he had a right to do so. He had the right, and I really don't know how to actually avoid that. Also, poor Ghost. The hood is almost torn. Let's see, what time is it? 10:11. Usually I go to bed by now. I probably should, don't you guys think? Maybe I should drive my ghost around a bit, maybe. Around the completed section of the tunnel. Don't worry, there's actually a particle effect down there. Showing that the ghost does work. One time, I think I was able to drive a ghost up here. One time, I think, or at least up this here. I heard a spider. I wonder how the villager down there is doing. Hey, buddy. Yeet. I know there's. I bet there's a spider up there waiting to ambush me. Trust me, I bet there is. I know he's around here somewhere. Hey, buddy. It's raining. Prolonged period of monster spawning. That's what that means to me. I'm getting tired. I guess I should end the video. But guys, I hope you enjoyed. And I hope I get better. Twizzles.